would you like to talk about today, Yunaka?
This isn't easy for me, but I want you to know why I've had a hard time telling the truth. So, I'm just going to lay it all out there, okay? The truth is, I used to be...
It's all right. You don't have to tell me.
But
I can see how hard this is for you. It's obvious just looking at your face. I told you before that I won't pry. It really is as simple as that.
You're really okay with me keeping a secret from you like this?
Of course. I have secrets too, you know. There's no need to make yourself uncomfortable. I only want to hear what you are ready to tell me.
Thank you. Sincerely, what I'm ready to say is that I'm truly grateful to have a friend like you in my life. I feel like I've finally found that place in the world I was looking for, you know? That's entirely thanks to you. And I won't forget it. I'm glad to fight for you and all our friends.
I really appreciate that, Yunaka.
I'll tell you all I can about my past. But I think the present is what matters. Us, here and now, we're just getting to know each other. There's so much more to say. It's like an adventure.
An adventure. I like that. I look forward to continuing this journey with you, Yunaka. Lapis, I wanted to thank you for all of your support in our recent battles.
Oh, I didn't really do much out there. I was just following your lead. You don't have to thank me for that, Divine One. There were lots of other more skilled warriors in those battles. You should thank them instead.
Lapis, please. You're strong and you think fast. You should have confidence in your abilities.
Confidence? I don't know about that. I'm thrilled to be a retainer. But everyone else is much more qualified. I'm not even a noble. I wouldn't want to sound arrogant when I rank so far beneath everyone else.
Wow, you're pretty hard on yourself, huh? I guess that can be a good motivator. But you shouldn't compare yourself to others like that. Everyone has different skills. Be a little more kind to yourself, okay? Like I said, you've earned a bit of confidence.
But, well, Divine One, I'm not sure what to say to all of that. I'm not used to being complimented like this. I should go. Please excuse me.
Lapis sounds so sure that she doesn't really belong here. There has to be some way to help her work past that mindset.
You are, Alfred. A barbarian in princess clothing.
Huh. What a nice thing to say. Thanks, Celine.
How did that strike you as a compliment?
You meant that I've got muscles all over like a barbarian, right? That's real praise, even if you're just saying it because I'm your brother.
That is not at all how I meant it.
Hey, it's okay, Celine. If that wasn't the idea, then what did you mean by it?
Your first impulse on hearing we were low on water was to dig a well.
Oh, right. Some mix-up, huh? Boy, was my face red.
Would that it were the only example. What about the time you heard some soldiers wishing they could cleanse themselves? You immediately leapt to dig them a hot spring.
Oh. Do we not like hot springs?
That isn't my point. Why is your first instinct always to go digging?
Because it's good training.
Save your breath. It's instincts like that that mark you as barbaric, which would be fine for most men, but you are a prince. Try to act the part.
All right, Celine, I get your point. From now on, I'm gonna train even harder. No more skip days. Pretty soon, I'll be so beefy that everyone can tell right off what a barbarian I am. No more confusion.
Ugh. Once again, you have completely missed the point.
Lapis? I want to apologize for making that vow the other day.
Oh, but Prince Alchrist, Please, don't worry about it. I should apologize for trying to tell you what you're allowed to say.
You did nothing wrong. It was my mistake. I didn't consider how my words would make you feel. However, there is one thing I'll stand by. I really do think that you're an amazing person, Lapis.
That's not... I'm really not that amazing.
You are. I know that you are. I know that you always send part of your pay back home to support your family. I also know you spend your free time subduing dangerous beasts that enter the area.
How did you find out about...
You're so much more valuable to this world than I am, Lapis. That's why I...
That's why you keep saying that you should be protecting me. Oh, Prince Alchrist. You have no idea. It breaks my heart to hear you talk like this. I'm sorry. I have to go.
Wow. I really am useless. I can't even let a close retainer know how much I appreciate her without upsetting her. I'm unfit to be anyone's master. Thank you.
Listen.
So, very nice.
What'll it be? How hard do you want to go? How hard do you want to go? What'll it be? Do you want to go? Looking good. Perfect. You've got this. Looking good. Perfect. You've got this. Keep it up. Nice. looking good. Great job! I'm so proud. Let's do this again sometime.
Yes. You came!
I'd rather eat than cook, but I'll do my best. So if I put this here, what a picturesque dish. It came out so well.
Lovely aroma.
Quite a pleasant flavor.
It tastes better if you...
Yes. Thank you.
Oh, Ivy. Did you need something from me?
No, Divine One. Must I require something to remain near you?
No, it's not that.
I see. Then please, feel free to ignore me.
I would, but it's difficult to ignore the anger on your face. The Kingdom of Illusia worships the Fel Dragon, doesn't it? If that's the case, I can certainly see why you would feel uncomfortable around me.
You can't imagine how I feel.
Well, if you can explain it, I'd love to understand. It might reduce this distance between us.
True, but we should get used to each other first. We'll talk when we're more comfortable. For now, I will leave you be and worship from afar.
Worship?
I'll be here.
Thank you. it to me.
Yes.
Go ahead. I can fight. Guided by the emblems.
ready and able. I will atone.
Understood.
Here goes.
Your steward's ready.
I'm guided by the emblems.
Thank you.
beautiful while you lasted. Here we go!
Nothing left of you.
Sorry you're stuck with me. I see you! That's Brodia for you.
Allow me.
You put up a good fight.
Was that too much?
eventually wilt.
Me.
Victory is mine.
Emblem, engage.
Give up.
Bonds give me strength.
Emblem, engage!
forget your loss.
Yeah. Divine Dragon!
I'm ready. I had no choice but to win.
I can fight.
No mistakes. Grant me strength. A good wind.
Go ahead.
I'm ready.
Open up shop! This item! I'll be good!
I did that.
Here I go.
I won't flinch. Victory is mine.
And curses upon our enemy.
Remember.
Together forever.
Unforgivable.
A proud victory.
eventually wilt.
This is enough. I'm still alive? Huh.
This time, victory is mine.
I can't believe I did that.
Lend me your strength.
Understood.
Understood.
I will obey.
Whatever you say.
Say the word.
Me? I'm sorry.
Emblem, engage. Watch this.
A good wind.
The divine dragon looked at me. I smell gold.
Here goes. Thousand curses upon our enemy.
I
wind.
And curses upon our enemy.
Nothing left of you.
Emblem, engage!
Yeah.
believe I did that.
begin. Fall! Tenacious!
A thousand curses upon our enemy.
That's it. And so, the knight claimed victory.
I will atone.
Be together forever.
This ends now.
I had to stop you.
Thank you.
afraid anymore.
This ends now.
I had to stop you.
I've had my eye on you.
I'm sorry. Rest now.
I'm getting hungry.
Will atone.
Me?
Here we go!
A satisfying ending.
I'll manage.
You were beautiful while you lasted.
choice but to win.
Nothing left of you.
I'll do my best. Lend me your...
I've got to hang on.
Rent. Let's be careful.
What a lovely scene.
I'm still alive? Huh.
upon our enemy.
Still do more.
And so, the knight claimed victory.
Thank you.
think me a worthy opponent?
I am Lynn of the Lorca tribe.
I must be faster.
I suppose. Your ring is something of an heirloom in my family. I suppose that makes things awkward.
Not at all. I spent many years in your father's company. King Hyacinth treated me well.
Royal Knight of Firinae.
Ivy, Crown Princess of Illusia.
If I win, you'd better buy something.
I am Zelkov, retainer to Princess Ivy.
I'm Lady Anna, the mysterious merchant.
I am Louis, Royal Knight of Firinae. Yeah!
This should be a picturesque match.
I am Lucina. Let's see what you can do.
I always do my best. Now and in the matches to come.
Hey, Lucina. If you have time, do you want to come to the market with me?
That sounds delightful. I'm so very interested in seeing the settlements of this world.
Do come again.
Hello, Zelkov. I'm Anna, but you can call me Lady Anna for short. Nice meeting you.
What a delightful child you are. What can I do for you, child? What is it you need?
Huh?
Is there anything I can get for you? Are you getting enough to eat?
I'm not hungry, if that's what you're asking me.
I hope I am not frightening you. That is not at all my intention.
Who says I'm scared? Real merchants like me see all kinds in our line of work. If I wanted sweets, I'd just buy some from myself.
I see. Well, good.
Which brings me back to why I'm here. You should buy something.
Yes, of course. Show me your merchandise.
Sure thing! I'm not sure I like the sound of that sigh.
I am afraid to say there is nothing here worth purchasing.
What?
While it grieves me to speak so harshly to a child, these goods are worthless to me.
Hang on just a minute. What's wrong with the stuff I sell?
If I must harden my heart to explain, so be it. There is no passion in your products.
What's that supposed to mean?
I can see how failing to understand that would lead you to sell these things in the first place.
Excuse me?
A product must bear the indelible mark of its creator's passion. It has no value otherwise.
What's the difference even between a product with passion and one without? Show me!
Very well. I possess many such wonders. I would be happy to show them to you.
This ought to be good. Do you want to help me look after the shop? It's sure to be popular with both of us there.
Me? Tend the shop? That sounds fun. If I get to do it with you, Lady Anna, then I want to try.
This is Solm.
It's very... sandy.
The Queendom's land is covered in deserts. I believe this one is called Tula. And, as you've no doubt noticed, it's much hotter than in Illusia. I fear I may melt.
What now, Divine One?
We'd better head straight to the palace. I just hope the hounds haven't gotten there first.
During my time in Illusia, the four hounds did pay a few visits to Solm. But they came back empty-handed each time, so I expect the palace is unharmed.
Thanks, Ivy. Pretty handy having an enemy as a friend.
I will choose to take that as a compliment.
Which emblem ring was entrusted to Solm?
The Radiant Hero. Said to be among the most powerful. Needless to say, it would be quite a boon.
Sounds like exactly what we need right now. Let's get going. Let's see. Which way to the palace again?
Divine One, I believe we passed that enormous rock earlier.
What? Really? All this terrain looks the same to me.
I wish I could help. My knowledge of Solmic geography comes only from maps. Wait a moment. Prince Alfred, Prince Diamant, your nations are allied with Solm. Haven't you gone to the palace before?
I did, but quite a long time ago. I don't remember the way.
I traveled from Firinae. I've got no clue how to get there from Illusia.
So none of us knows where to go. All right, I'll say it. We're lost.
I'm afraid so. We can't afford to waste time. I wonder if there's a landmark to go by.
You don't look like you're from around here. What's with the outfits? Sorry, I didn't mean to startle you, but I took one look and thought to myself, self, they are lost.
And, who are you?
Who am I? I'm the guy, here to keep the peace in Tula Desert. Call me Fogato, yeah? As captain of the Sentinels, it's my duty to help people in need. If you find folks need a hand, just let me know.
Thanks for that. As for myself, I'm the Divine Dragon, from Lethos.
Wait, you who? You're telling me the Divine Dragon is here, in my desert? No kidding?
Yes.
Oh, I had no idea. I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to be rude.
You weren't. There's no need to be formal with me.
Didn't expect you to be casual. That's cool. But hey, what brings you all out to my piece of the world?
We're on our way to Solm Palace, but we don't know how to get there.
This is your lucky day. Come on, just follow me. If I know how to get anywhere, it's the palace.
You don't mind?
Of course I don't. You know what's out there? Sand, as far as the eye can see. And I would rather you not have to deal with that. Lucky we met, huh?
Thank you, Fogato. We appreciate your help.
Don't sweat it. Oh, you know what? I do have a quick errand to take care of first.
An errand? What kind of errand?
More of a mission. See, not too long ago, these freaky creatures started appearing everywhere. As captain of the Sentinels, when I get a report about a problem in the desert, I take care of it. Sorry about this. You have a sit, and I'll take you to the palace right after I'm done.
Actually, why don't we come with you? We can help.
Well, that'd be great. My friends went ahead of me. Let's go meet up with them. The problem's even worse than I expected. Hey, there they are! Andrea! Renee!
Fogato, you're late. I was starting to think you wanted us to die out here.
With any further delay, these creatures would have made a meal of us.
Sorry about that, fellas. But hey, I brought help.
Help? What do you mean, help?
Oh, Pandreo, my pious friend.
Nice to meet you.
Oh, it's the Divine Dragon! The Divine Dragon! Hang on! What were you thinking, bringing the Divine Dragon here?
That hair. Like two scoops of sorbet swirling together in the desert heat.
Hey, save it for the kitchen. That's a deity you're talking about.
I knew this would get you two fired up. Divine One, these are my sentinel friends. What do you say? Ready to handle a mission with us?
Ready.
Let's do this thing, Sentinels.
Finally! Time to get this party started!
I will serve up a most deadly dish.
Before I forget, watch out for those patches of quicksand. That stuff will really slow you down.
Now I have you.
A good win.
I hear you.
As you wish.
Any customers?
Let's go!
They're cooked.
I can fight.
Divine One, it's such an honor. Please, use my abilities as you see fit. I can use my staff to warp you or an ally somewhere far away on the battlefield.
For the Divine Dragon!
Let's pray.
Excuse me.
foes are strong. Is it go time? Emblem, engage! I challenge my fate. I'm not alone anymore. I'll begin. Do my best.
lovely scene.
with me. Too close. For Brodia. That's Brodia for you.
Much.
From medium!
I'm ready to dig in. Yeah! Our bonds give me strength.
Thank you.
ready yourself.
Will protect everyone.
What would you make me do?
Another kill for me.
By the emblems.
I'll do my best.
I'll begin.
As you like.
Thank you.
I'll do my best.
I'm getting hungry.
Emblem, engage!
I'm ready.
while you lasted.
Glad to have peace in these parts again.
Phew!
Thank you.
Well.
Thanks.
Right.
If not for your help, I would...
That's right.
Thank you so much.
Yep.
Zappy.
Ah.
Fine work.
Well...
Aw, man. Not... Nice going. You really showed him what the Divine Dragon can do. Now, to Solm Palace. Stay close. I'd hate for you to split off and get lost. Again.
Thanks, Fogato.
This ought to be interesting. It's been years since I visited the palace.
Years? I thought Solm and Firine had a good relationship.
Our countries are allies, sure, but that doesn't mean our families are close-knit. In fact, out of Solm's whole royal family, my mother and I have only met Queen Sephoria.
What? No one else?
Nope. Not the royal consort, not the crown princess, and not her brother the prince.
That's strange.
I never met them either.
Same thing happened to you, huh?
I may have forgotten the way to the palace, but I remember well what happened there. was a strange scene. The queen received us alone, with no one attending her. When we asked to meet the princess and prince, she told us they weren't there.
She told us the exact same thing. I asked when they'd be back, and she said, no idea. It didn't make sense. If you're royalty, you can't leave your castle whenever you like. I got the feeling she was hiding them from us. But why? Were they sick or shy?
Shy? That would surprise me. Everyone we've met here has been so friendly.
The queen is too. There are just some things about the royal family that don't add up. Let's be on guard, all right?
Got it.
We're here. Soul Palace. Now all that's left is asking those guards to open the gate.
Thanks for leading the way, Fogato. I don't know how we'd have gotten here without you.
Of course. Just another day in the life of a sentinel.
I'll be sure to commend you to the queen. Anyway, now we'd better be on our way. Huh? Fogato? What are you doing?
Talking to the guards. What else?
Does he have a meeting with the queen as well?
Beats me. Maybe he's here on some kind of sentinel business.
Fogato, wait for us!
Hey, I'm home!
Home?
Welcome back, Prince Fogato.
I'll open the gate.
Yes, let the gate be open!
Prince. Did that guard say Prince?
Unless we misheard him. In exactly the same way.
Thanks for waiting, folks.
Fogato, we're a little confused. Are you the Prince of Solm?
Did I not mention that?
No, you didn't.
Whoops, egg meat face. Right, let me do this properly. I'm Fogato, Captain of the Sentinels, and the Prince of Solm. Welcome to my family's palace. Come on in. You wanted to meet Mom, right? Mom! Visitors!
What is happening?
I didn't realize he was royalty.
A prince personally going on patrols. Not something you see every day.
I wonder why we never met him before. He doesn't seem sick. He's certainly not shy.
It's a mystery. Anyway, let's head in. Don't want to keep Prince Fogato waiting.
Stolen, miserable, torn apart from your friends. How delicious.
Lady Vale.
Zephia, tell me, what are the Divine Dragon's forces up to?
They passed through the Shadowy Moor. It appears they've arrived in Solm.
So they did not return to Brodia. They're gathering more rings.
Good.
Can we go after them, Lady Vale? I'm itching for a rematch. Patience, Marnie. If we wait, we can steal Solm's ring from them along with the others.
Oh, smart. I'll be a good girl and wait then.
You are a treasure, Marnie.
Isn't she just? The pride of the Four Hounds.
You two really heap on the praise. That's why I love ya.
You're such a child. Praise is for chumps. It's much more fun to be punished.
Worry not, Gris. You will soon have all the agony your heart could want.
That's what I like to hear. The perks of the gig right there.
And you, Mavir? How would you like to be rewarded?
Nothing for me, my lady.
You won't even say my name. How cold. That's all right. For now, we wait. We watch. And then, when the time comes...
Lady Vale?
I've been awake for too long. I'm asleep. Here are your instructions. Zephia, take charge.
As you wish.
Maybe I'm coming at this wrong.
What are you thinking about, Anna?
Oh, that's Lady Anna to you. But to answer your question, I'm brainstorming new products.
More stuff to sell, huh?
Yep. You know what Sweetheart's Day is?
I think I've heard of it. It's where couples give each other gifts, right?
That's the one. Usually people just give each other flowers, but the same old gift every year loses its luster. So, I'm out to market something mind-blowing that'll bring the spark back to Sweetheart's Day.
Wow, that's a pretty lofty goal.
Oh, quit treating me like a kid and help me out here, Divine One. Nothing I've come up with so far has grabbed me, so I could use someone else's input.
Let's see here. Something new for Sweetheart's Day. How about necklaces?
I see you have your finger on the pulse of the average Sweetheart's Day participant. Necklaces are almost as played out as flowers. They're hardly going to blow anyone's mind.
Oh, I see.
Customers don't want something they can get anywhere. They want something one of a kind. Oh, the constant need to come up with goods like that is what makes my line of work so tricky.
Got it. I'll keep thinking. We'll come up with something good eventually.
I'm sorry if you worry about me. If not for the war, I could vanish and avoid being a nuisance.
You are a prince, aren't you? Sometimes it's like I'm talking with my old classmate again.